from November to February, if you look at the sky, you may see the Orion constellation. It's one of the brightest and best known constellations in the sky. Two of the 10 brightest stars in the sky are in this constellation, Rigel and Betelgeuse. The Orion constellation also contains one of the brightest nebulae. It's called the ORION Nebula, and it's a huge stellar nursery. When we watch this nebula from a telescope, we can see at its heart a very young star cluster known as the Trapezium. And these four massive young stars are the heavier stars in this nebula. The ORION Nebula is 1500 light years away from Earth, and it's the nearest star-forming region we have. And the most important characteristic of this nebula is that never let you down. If you have a new telescope and struggle to find objects, if you have a small telescope, if you are busy and only have a bit of time that night to watch the sky, if you have just some clouds but you were almost a month with cloudy nights, completely closed the sky, and you are wanting so much to watch something in the sky, this nebula will not let you down. And so many people all over the world, like me, want so much to watch this nebula and also to take a picture of it, to do some astrophotography. So that's what we're gonna do today, to watch it doing EAA electronically assisted astronomy, and then astrophotography, a little tweak to enhance that image. And to watch the ORION Nebula in real time, we will use this 8-inch Dobsonian telescope over an equatorial platform. Also, my ZWO-294 camera will be used, and I will reveal in a moment a nice trick to use when capturing large objects like this nebula, which are hard to frame in a camera field of view. After having the 8-inch Dobsonian aimed, we will now open the SharpCap Pro software to capture this beautiful nebula. I'm moving the telescope, trying to point it to the nebula. Of course, I always struggle a bit. But in this case, the ORION Nebula, it's a very bright and large nebula, easy to find. And now that I found it, I will try to place it at the center of the screen. And this is it. Done. Now I will try to focus the best I can, moving the focuser up and down, as I show in a previous video.
Please subscribe and give it a like!
A good advice to you from my children, if you like to watch my content. And it's free. Look how I slowly get the stars into focus. The goal is to have pinpoint stars. We got to do it nice and steady, because every time I touch the focuser, the telescope moves a bit. So I touch and stay. I touch and wait until I get the image I want. This is important to have a good focus in order to have a good image. And the SharpCap software, which we are using to do the live stack, will work much better with pinpoint stars. At least we will do the best we can. And we did it. And now I will show you the secret I have to frame this nebula better. I have always the camera in a position in the focuser which allows me to move left and right, up and down in real position. But like that, the arms of this nebula, at least at this moment, will be on vertical, so will be cut. In this particular situation, the trick I do is to rotate slowly the camera on the focuser until I get a diagonal. Look what I'm doing. You see? Now it's much better framed, and we can proceed with a life stack. We will use 10 second exposures. In my EAA playlist on my channel, you have plenty of videos explaining how this process is made in detail. Waiting for the first green frame to enter. And bam, here he can. With only 10 seconds, we have already a bright image. Now let's tweak the histogram. Autocolor. And bam, now it's even better in colors. Now the auto stretch. Just waiting for this frame to finish. And bam, this is getting interesting. Adjusting the histogram bars. And oh boy, look at this image. Look at this beautiful image. This is the Dobsonian power in action, live action. And now we are going to skip to the last stage, where we have already almost 10 minutes of live stacking. That means we were enjoying in real time during 10 minutes this beautiful object in the sky in our laptop. Now we will stop, save as scene, and then just do a bit of astrophotography to give a bit more of detail. Now look at this majestic image. Remember, the Orion Nebula never let you down, and neither do I. So click on one of those videos on the screen to watch more of my astronomic adventures with a telescope. Thank you very much for watching.